Namaskar. Today's topic is receptor regulation. There are various drugs that cause addiction or tolerance or withdrawal syndrome, or they are habit forming in nature. Why these drugs have such pharmacological properties? How these drugs develop such pharmacological properties? These all can be explained by studying this topic, that is the receptor regulation. So today we will try to understand this receptor regulation, and we will try to find out how and why these drugs are addictive drugs, or they are habit forming drugs, or they have a withdrawal syndrome, or they produce the tolerance. There are three keywords in this topic. Number one is the homeostasis, number three is the ligands, and number four is the receptors. First is the homeostasis. Our body or organ or cells always maintain the homeostasis. It is a vital process that is developed by our body during the evolution. This homeostasis means ability of the organ or cells to maintain its constant internal environment irrespective of any change in the external environment. Suppose our atmospheric temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, or it is 4 degrees Celsius, but our body normal body temperature always maintained at the 37 degrees Celsius. The ability of the body to maintain this temperature 37 degrees Celsius irrespective of any changes in the atmospheric temperature, this is called homeostasis. Means suppose there is a cell perform its some physiological properties. If there is any change in the external environment of the cells, there will be no change in the internal environment of the cells, and cell will perform its normal physiological property, and ability of the cells to perform the normal physiological property irrespective of the changes in the external environment of the cell, that is called the homeostasis. Number second is the ligands. Ligands are the substances that may be exogenous in nature or that may be endogenous in nature. Endogenous like neurotransmitters or hormones that combine with the receptors to produce the biological effect or physiological effect or pharmacological effect. If it is endogenous, it will produce the biological effect. If it is exogenous, it will produce the pharmacological effect. And third one is the receptors. We all know receptors are proteinous macromolecules present on the surface of the cell or on the cell membrane or inside the cell, inside the cytoplasm, that combine with the ligands to produce some biological effect or physiological effect or pharmacological effect. Extent of this biological effect or pharmacological effect depend upon the number of ligands combined with the receptors, means number of inputs cells are receiving from these ligands, and that will decide the extent of the action, that is the physiological action or the biological actions. Cells have ability to increase number of receptors or to decrease number of receptors, means cells have ability to destroy the receptors or to synthesize the receptors, and all these are to maintain the homeostasis. Suppose there are very less number of ligands outside the cell membrane. In that condition, cells will sense that there is some problem, because cell is not receiving such input, required input from these ligands to produce their normal physiological functions. In that condition, cell will increase number of receptors so that it can combine with the maximum number of ligands to produce the normal physiological functions. Just opposite, suppose there are large number of ligands present outside the cell membrane. In that condition, receptors will combine with all these ligands and produce the physiological effect that may be much, much more than the required or normal physiological effect. In this condition, cell will decrease its number of receptors from the cell surface so that it can combine only those ligands to produce normal physiological actions or biological actions. And this increase in number of receptors or decrease in number of receptors is a receptor regulation just to maintain the homeostasis. It means receptor regulation is a vital process to maintain the normal function of our body. We can define it as receptor regulation, increase in number of receptors or decrease in number of receptors is called a receptor regulation just to produce the homeostasis. Here there is two words. Number one is the increase in number of receptors and number two is the decrease in number of receptors. It means we can divide this receptor regulation into the two groups, two parts, two types. Number one is the upregulation and number two is the downregulation. First one is the upregulation. Name clear from this word upregulation. That increase in number of receptors is called upregulation. If there is increase in number of receptors at the cell surface, it means cell will become the super sensitive and it will combine with the ligands to produce the normal effective. As we have explained, if there are very few ligands present outside the cell membrane, in that conditions, cell will not receive the required input to produce the its normal physiological effective. In that condition, cells will synthesize new receptors and migrate it or transport it to the cell membrane so that it can grab maximum number of ligands to produce the normal biological or physiological effect, and this is called the upregulation of the receptors. We can see it from the diagram. This is a cell, and there are very few ligands present outside the cell. In that condition, there are only two receptors. What will happen? The cells will synthesize new receptors and it will increase the number of receptors. It will increase the number of receptors so that it combines maximum number of ligands to produce the pharmacological or biological effect. And this is called the upregulation. These upregulations have some characteristics. Number one, cell will reduce degeneration of the receptors present on the cell surface. Cells will increase activation or cell will activate the receptors present at the cell surface. Cell will synthesize nucleic acids. Cell will synthesize new receptors and cell will migrate these receptors or transport these receptors to the cell membrane so that it can bind with the maximum number of ligands to produce the required physiological effect or pharmacological effect. And this is our upregulations. In the aging or in the disease condition like hyperthyroidism, heart problem, the upregulations occur. Take an example of dopamine. We all know deficiency of dopamine causes Parkinsonism in our disease. But it does not happen in all human body or all humans that the Parkinsonism is developed with the aging. With the aging, number of nerve cells decreases. It means the nerve cells that produce the dopamine also decreases. It means the number of dopamines, hormone number of the dopamine will decrease. And in that condition, cell will not receive much number of or required number of dopamine to produce the physiological effect, and that will develop the Parkinsonism. But we all know, in all people, this Parkinson is not developed. Because if there is decrease in number of dopamine, as with the aging, our nerve cells increase the number of receptors so that it can combine the dopamine to produce the normal functions of these nerve cells. And this is called the upregulation. Second one is the downregulation. What is downregulation? From this name, very clear, decrease in the number of receptors at the cell surface is called downregulation. Suppose there are large number of ligands present in the external environment of the cells, and these numbers present chronically for the longer period they are remaining at the outer surface of the cell membrane. In that condition, these ligands will combine with the receptor and it produce the physiological effect that will be much more than the required physiological effect or the normal physiological effect. That will be harmful for the cells or dangerous for the cells or maybe toxic in nature. To counter this toxicity, to counter this poisonous effect, to counter this danger, cell decreases its receptors number from the cell surface and so that it can combine only required number of ligands to produce the physiological effect, and this is called the downregulations. There are some characteristics of this downregulations also. Number one, there will be increase in there will be decrease in number of receptors. We can see this from this diagram. Suppose there is a number of regions that combine with the receptor and are producing the toxic effect or the poisonous effect. In that condition, these receptors will go under the endocytosis or under the internalization. Internalization means the movement of these receptors inside the cytoplasm. Inside the cytoplasm, these receptors and regions will be destroyed by the Golgi body or lysosomes, and this will decrease the number of receptors. These are the phenomena where number of receptors decreases, and this is called the down regulation. Means down regulation is the internalization or endocytosis of the receptors to maintain the homeostasis or to produce the normal physiological property effect of the cells. There are some characteristics of this down regulation. Number one is that there will be increase in degradation of the receptors. Number of receptors will increase. Degradation will increase. Number two, there will be increase in the endocytosis. Number three, there will be decrease in the nucleic acid synthesis. There will be decrease in the receptor synthesis. And all these will called desensitization of the cell membrane. Means the cell membrane will be desensitized so that lesions cannot combine with the receptors to produce the effect. And in another, in upregulation, there will be the increase in that will be the sensitization. Means upregulation means sensitization of the cell, and downregulation means desensitization of the cell. Here is the example of diagram for the downregulation. Here are there large number of receptors and large number of ligands that produce the pharmacological or biological, exhibited biological effect. In this condition, cells will decrease the number of receptors and number of receptors become very less so that it can combine only the required number of ligands to produce the biological or pharmacological effect. So these are the detail of the our receptor regulations. Now, question is how the drug develop addiction or tolerance or withdrawal syndrome or their habit forming in nature. Take an example of opium, morphine. Suppose a person is a chronic user of the morphine. What will happen? In that condition, cells will receive the opium, opioid receptors will be combined with this morphine and it produce the action. And that is the harmful for the body. In that condition, cell will decrease its number of the receptors. And that decreasing number of receptors will cause tolerance effect. It means we have to give a large number of opium to produce the exaggerated effect or the toxic effect or the toxic effect for the morphine. So this is called the tolerance to increase that need to require the increase of the drug dose. Suppose we suddenly stop the administration of the morphine, what will happen? Cells have a very few number of receptors and the endogenous opiate will not be combined with the sufficient number of receptors to produce the pharmacological effect or to produce the normal biological effect. In that condition, the withdrawal syndrome will start, means our body will not feel normal due to absence of the opiate receptors that combine with the natural opioids present inside the body. So these produce the withdrawal syndrome. Second is take the example of caffeine. We take the caffeine combined with the adenosine receptors and to produce the effect. Suppose we suddenly stop the use of caffeine, what will happen? There will be the less number of the receptors present outside the cell surface. Our body adenosine will not be able to combine with that receptor and body will not feel the normal function, normal things. And in this condition, there will be withdrawal syndrome and person will like to take the coffee to feel the normal. There are various examples of that. There are various experiments of others, but due to the limited time frame, I am just stopping the heat and hoping this explanation is understandable and you have clarified what is the receptor regulation. Thank you very much for viewing this video.